नमस्कार एंड वेलकम अगेन टू प्लैनेट टू सोल एस्ट्रोलॉजी। सो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वंडरफुल। एंड यस, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट महादशा लॉर्ड इन योर नवमांश कुंडली। नवमांश कुंडली इज वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ एवरी वन। इन लास्ट सेशन आई ट्राइड टू स्पीक अबाउट इट, बट देन आई एंड अप विथ यू नो BTR, दैट इज बर्थ टाइम रेक्टिफिकेशन। बट यू नो दैट टॉपिक वॉज इन माई माइंड सिंस मेनी डेज। एंड सी, वेन वी आर सीइंग नवमांश कुंडली, नवमांश कुंडली और एनी कुंडली इज अ नेवर एंडिंग स्टोरी। यू कैन नॉट से दैट यू आर नाउ फुलफिल्ड विथ ऑल द नॉलेज रिगार्डिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्ग चार्ट। ओके, नो, एवरी डे यू गेट न्यू थिंग्स इन योर वर्ग कुंडली। सो जस्ट सी वेर योर महादशा लॉर्ड इज लाइंग इन योर नवमांश कुंडली। इफ द महादशा लॉर्ड, विच एवर साइन एंड विच एवर हाउस दैट महादशा लॉर्ड इज पोजिटेड, दैट हाउस रिलेटेड कारकत्व और सिग्निफिकेशन, दैट हाउस रिलेटेड फ्रूट्स 110% दैट महादशा लॉर्ड इज गोइंग टू गिव यू। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू आर रनिंग मर्क्यूरी महादशा and in your Navamansha Kundali you have Pisces ascendant rising and Mercury is going in 12th house of chart. So what one will see that this person's Mahadasha Lord, which is Mercury, which is also happening to be Lord of 7th house and 4th house, is going in 12th house of chart. So definitely this person may be away from homeland whenever this Dasha will start, or whenever Mercury Saturn, because Mercury is in Aquarius sign, in Saturn sign. So whenever Mercury Saturn or Mercury Saturn or Mercury Saturn Rahu Dasha will fall, then definitely this person will be likely to go out of country. Because why? Because along with D1 chart, wherever your Mahadasha Lord is posited in your Navamsha chart also, that house is also getting activated to give you fruits. You just simply assess it 110%, you will be getting the fruits. What you should do, already you see the dasha already which has passed, so it will be much better for you to understand or learn it, and then you can judge about the future events, you know. So as I was giving example that Mercury is posited in 12th house of your chart, right? So now this 12th house will be definitely aspecting your 6th house also, right? So 6th house is also getting activated because Mercury only has one aspect, that is 7th aspect. So immediately this Mercury is aspecting friend sign of Leo, right? Then you have to see where this Surya is going in your chart. In Navamansha I am talking. And then you have to see the Mercury and Surya connectivity with each other. If they are very good, like they are in trine to each other, they are together, they are 3-11 position, or they are aspecting each other pratiyog, that is 180 degree opposite to each other, or in D1 chart also, if Mercury happens to be in Surya Nakshatra or Surya happens to be in Mercury Nakshatra, then definitely when Mercury Surya Dasha will fall, you will experience fantastic fruits in terms of your job, post, position, hike, increment, change of work profile, so many things. Third thing, you just have to see your Mahadasha Lord Nakshatra. Now, as I was talking about Mercury, so in D1 chart, if your Mercury is of Rahu Nakshatra, say Satabhisha Nakshatra. So in D9 chart, this Rahu Nakshatra Mercury is posited in 12th house of chart. 12th house is deep sadhana, deep meditation, open sky. 12th house is also Moksha Trikona. So maybe this person will be more attached or more attracted towards awakening of self-realization, awakening of Kundalini, awakening of meditation quality in it, or so many things you can see. Maybe this person will be more working towards a public cause, social cause, maybe public sector work this person will be doing, right? And then again it is in Rahu Nakshatra, so you cannot judge the exact work what this person will be doing. That is also another thing. See, so beautiful this is. you know. And then you have to see where Rahu is posited in a chart, how that Mercury and Rahu are connected to each other. Many people see that Rahu has 5-9-7 aspect. I have never seen till now. I always consider opposite aspect for Rahu Ketu because they are opposite to each other 180 degree, and that is a one body, so definitely the half body is looking at another half body. But when we see that this Rahu and Mercury, which is your Mahadasha Lord in Navmansh Kundali, they are in very well positive. Let's say for example in D9 chart, as Mercury falls in Aquarius sign, and if Rahu is falling in Kanya Rashi in D9 chart, in Pisces ascendant, that means Mahadasha Lord and Lord Nakshatra, Mercury Lord Nakshatra, Rahu is posited in 7th house, so they are sadashtak to each other, 6-8 to each other. That means some or other way, because Rahu is in Kanya Rashi in 7th house, 7th house related matters, partnership related matters may suffer. But as Rahu is in a Kanya Rashi, which is said to be favorable sign of Rahu, so maybe this outgoing phase, that is foreign going phase, or maximum time visiting or travels are getting really activated. At the same time, 6th number sign falls on our intestine and Rahu and Mercury Dasha is there. So definitely during this period, Mercury Rahu or Mercury Rahu Dasha, stomach related issues, digestion related issues, gaseous issues may arise. Then whether it will be serious, whether it will be severe or very mild, that again Mars will decide. That we will see later on. One by one we will take all the topics. But till now, you have to see your Mahadasha Lord in your Navmansh Kundali. Where my Mahadasha Lord is going in my Navmansh Kundali. If you are running, say for example, if you are running Rahu Dasha, right? And in your Navmansh Kundali, Rahu is posited in 7th house of chart. Say for example, it is a Scorpio ascendant. So Rahu is going in Taurus sign, again in a favorable sign. But one thing keep in mind, once this Rahu Dasha will start, definitely this will activate your 7th house. And in D1 chart where it is posited, you have to see. Say for example, in D1 it is posited in 4th house of chart. Then again 4th house is getting activated, change of place, going out of country, health related issues, mother related issues, or relationship with your family members, house change. But how to see the deeper meaning of that? Then see 7th house of Navmansh Kundali where this Rahu Mahadasha Lord is posited. There you will see that Rahu is in Taurus sign, so definitely this person may fall in love, and whoever this person is in love, this person will decide to marry that person because Rahu is just jumping in that 7th house to give the fruits. But when that marriage will happen, that will again be decided when it is posited in Venus sign. So let Venus Antardasha comes, or let Jupiter Antardasha comes, or let Mars Antardasha comes, you know, or let Jupiter transit comes over there. If it is a marriageable age, right? If it is a student age and this type, then definitely there will be distraction from study. You do not know what to do. You do not have any clear idea about your work because this Rahu is posited 10th to your 10th house in your Navmansh Kundali. You do not know what you want to do in life. You are just kolu ke bel ki tarah. You are doing, going and going and going. You are doing some work, but ultimately you do not have any idea what you have to do further. And then you again always have that query in your mind that what I have to do, what should I do, what profession I should select. After certain age also, still all these queries are there in your mind. This is Rahu, friends. Then again, as I said before, you have to see that which nakshatra this Rahu is posited. So in D1 again I will see that Rahu is posited in Shukra nakshatra, that is Venus nakshatra in Kanya Rashi. in fourth house of chart, that means it is a Gemini ascendant, right? So again I will see that yes, this person will be creative, so creativity will be at peak when Rahu Dasha will start, and then when Chandra or Venus Dasha, Antar Dasha will be there. So many good things we can see. So friends, this was just a brief introduction about your Mahadasha Lord in Navmansh Kundali. Next time I will come with another topic. By that time, stay tuned with Planet Soul Astrology. Do not forget to subscribe my channel. Also, do subscribe my Hindi channel. By that time, Sabka Mangal Ho. May all be blessed. Namaste.